What?
Thank you.
soul.
I've been waiting for you. We are fortunate.
Go then.
Hello there, darling.
Well, hello to you.
How goes the search?
Tell me.
Thank you.
ain't you?
Well met. I will need to see your pass, if you would be so kind.
Are you another ambassador? Have these fool wizards invited everyone to their tower den?
For the Oath Guard!
Oh.
Stand before me! Thank you. Pilgrim's followers. You're not, are you?
Thank you. I do.
Will you lead our glorious army in the name of your new mistress?
I will. I will lead them.
Then be the terrifying blackguard of our mistress Mora that you are meant to.
I shall. Neverwinter will fall before our might.
Remember, Morgrim, that it is of great importance that the other words of power be located. You must be there hatefully, however, as she will. You have been lax, Morgrim. We have intruders. The word of power cannot fall into the hands of the enemy. You take care of them. I shall summon my own souls to do this.
Fortunate that you have found the location of this cult, hiding amongst the wizards of Luskan's host tower.
Well done, my friend. I knew Lord Nash's faith in you was well justified.
I see. This enemy is far more elusive than I suspected even, but Lady Arabeth has fallen to become a blackguard, and even leads their gathering armies.
It's far worse than anything I had feared.
But what of this Mogrim's purpose, my friend?
This is perhaps the first good news I have heard so far. Come then. Let us return to Lord Nashor quickly.
Within the host tower of the Arcane, the enemy was finally revealed. Morgrim Korothir, madman, prophet, the one responsible for the wailing death. And with this revelation, a second betrayal. Arabeth, driven mad by her lover's execution, sought vengeance by joining Mogrim's cause. Together, they roused a fearsome army and prepared to descend upon Neverwinter. But an even greater evil threatened the city. The words of power, remnants of ancient magic long forgotten, were being sought by Mogrim's followers to bring devastation to the north. Neverwinter's champions were sent to the northern wastes of the Uthgard tribes to unearth these lost artifacts. For if Morgrim were to find the words of power first, the city of the North would surely fall.
This has become something of a habit, has it not? Yet this time you will be reporting directly to me. To be honest, I much prefer to stay in the shadows. Yet Neverwinter has need of me, so Neverwinter has need of all her allies now. I have examined the reconnaissance reports of my operatives in the field. The Luskan armies are marching against Neverwinter with Erebeth at their head. Perhaps even more troubling are the reports of orcs and some of the Uthgard tribes joining Erebeth. And the Lord's Alliance has come to our aid, and several of the Uthgard stand with us. The Red Tiger and Black Lion tribes have made camp with us here at Biarun as well. But Erebeth and the Luskan army are best left to the generals in the field. Perhaps had we been more observant, Erebeth's betrayal would not have been such a surprise. She abandoned us. But part of me wonders if we did not first turn our backs on her suffering. Erebeth has vowed revenge against Neverwinter. I believe Erebeth and the Luskan invaders are but a decoy, a distraction. It has not been easy to gather information on Mogrim's cult, but we know they are frantically searching for the ancient artifacts, though we do not yet know what these words are or why Mogrim desires them. We know there are at least three of these. You must find these ancient words before Mogrim does. There are reports of Mogrim's followers searching throughout the land. I wish I had more guidance for you. Perhaps you can learn more from Lillian Cambridge. Lillian has promised to offer whatever help she can. I know this may seem an impossible task. I wish you luck in your mission.